Greetings, friends. David Marks here. There's a brand new feature called AI-powered Denoise inside of Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic. This new tool does an incredible job cleaning up noisy RAW files. This is a revolutionary advance in Lightroom's image processing capabilities. So let's jump right in and let's get started. On the screen right now is a long exposure image that is full of sensor noise. If I zoom in, then you can see all of these false red and green pixels and that sandstorm-looking speckled texture. The false red and green spots all over this image are called color or chroma noise, and that black pebbly texture, that's what we call luminance noise. Up till now, we've been able to confront these problems using these sliders down here in the details panel, but now there's a much better option. When I tap on this denoise button, a new window will appear. At first, the enlarged section of my image that we can see in this window on the left might not be all that helpful. So I'm going to tap on this little magnifying glass icon to zoom all the way back out. Next, I'm going to place the crosshair over a part of the image where the details matter, and then I'll tap to zoom in to make that the center of the preview window again. When the cursor is inside of this window, I can press and hold down on the left button on my mouse to see this photo without any noise reduction. And when I let go, I can see the AI Denoise enhanced preview. This preview window and the denoise amount slider just to its right, they allow for additional precision. But for now, I'm going to stick with the default settings. I'll tap on the big blue enhance button. Depending upon the speed of your computer, this process might take a while. This feature runs significantly faster on high-powered computers, but even on the best machines, expect this to take some processing time. When the denoise processing is finished, it will create a new DNG file. If I select this file and our original, and then if I compare these two side by side, the improvement here is jaw-dropping. Compare the file that Lightroom has labeled enhanced noise reduction to our dirty original. Not only is most of the noise gone, but there are architectural details like the word entrance that were obscured completely in my original. Let me show you another example, only this time I'm going to jump into the AI Denoise tool without starting from the develop module. To do that, I'm going to activate the photo enhance command from here on the menu bar. When this window opens, I'm going to tap on the zoom out icon again, and then I'll recenter this one over an area with good representative details. Last time, I left the amount slider at the factory default setting of 50, but on this image, that doesn't seem like enough noise reduction. To increase the strength of the AI denoise, I'm going to drag this slider up. Although it's tempting to crank the amount slider all the way to 100, the results now look a little too smooth. At 100%, this image looks kind of too clean and sort of fake. To find the right setting, I like to jump from 100 down to 75, and then from 75 down to 50. In this case, 50 looks a little too noisy. And 75, to my eyes, looks a little too smooth. So let's split the difference and go for something like 62. That looks good, so I'll tap Enhance. The point that I want to make there is that there is no magic setting for the amount slider. The amount of denoise that makes sense on one image might be too little or too much on another, so you're going to need to experiment. Now that we have our enhanced DNG file, I can select both of these images and show you another side-by-side comparison. With this new feature, Lightroom's noise reduction capabilities now meet or exceed anything that its rivals have to offer. If I were really working on this image at this point, I'd take my enhance file, I'd jump back into the develop module, and then I'd do more work from here. I could do anything and everything using all of the other controls that we know and love here in the develop module. But instead of completely processing this image right now, let me show you another trick. Our original here is a raw file that I shot one night while I was teaching a Northern Lights photography class up in the Arctic. The next image is very similar because, of course, I didn't just snap one photo while the aurora was dancing around the sky. Since these photos are almost the same, I would love to copy and paste my noise reduction from the first one to the second one. Unfortunately, if you try to do this using the Sync Develop Settings button, though, you'll be disappointed. You'll be frustrated because that AI Denoise command is not included in this sync menu like all of our other develop controls. Fortunately, there is a keyboard shortcut that you can use to apply the exact same denoise settings that we used on this photo to this one as well. On a Mac, the keyboard shortcut that you need is Shift plus Control plus Option and the letter I. On a PC, this secret denoise shortcut is Shift plus Control plus Alt and the letter I. Using this keyboard shortcut is a big time saver if you're working on a series of images like these, where the same settings will work for each image. Bam! Just like that, our second Aurora photo is clean. And now I could jump into the Develop module and add more edits into this one if I wanted to. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.